Okay, let's get moving on up. Today we're going to, so what have we done? We have our acapella, we have our chords, we have continued to tempo map a bit out of concern that the drums weren't lining up, they sound better. We have our keys, our chords for our piano-based instrument. Let me add to my agenda. We're going to, if we can get to it within a decent amount of time, we're going to change the keys sound. All right, we're going to do that by making our own patch. So that should be exciting. But first, so let's check out what we have here in our drums.
Burning cities in napalm skies, 15 flares inside those ocean eyes, your ocean eyes.
So I've always felt, so in the original, it picks up the energy by bringing the second snare drum in, kind of like dun ka. Okay, I'm changing my mind where we're going already. But basically, I'm gonna just use. I'm gonna just duplicate this last one and open it up and kind of play with it. So that was that at measure 14, okay? So I want to make sure that I'm looking at 14. I don't really want to listen to the original that much anymore, but I kind of like where that drum is. So that's actually on the 4th 16th note. So it's kind of an anticipation of beat 2. It's a 4th 16th note of beat 1. All right, we're going to be changing things as we go. I actually don't want it there. No, I'm going to put it on 2 and 4 for now. So I do want to have a second snare drum, but I'm going to do it differently, and I'm going to put it on beats 2 and 4. But I don't want all these kick drums, so that was kind of, I just wanted to duplicate it to save a couple of seconds. So I actually want a kick drum there, and then I want one here. So let me get my pencil so I can do it right. But I was hitting option, click, and drag. I don't know what the command is on a PC for that. Nah, right there. I'm just bringing up my velocities, or else I won't hear that drum very much. I like that. Actually, let's let that one sit. No, put that back, get rid of this one. Then I want hi-hats. So I really want to pick this up. So on F sharp, I'm going to put in, remember that our grid should be 16th notes. In Pro Tools First, you're just going to see that up here. Make sure that they're 16th notes. And I'm going to put in an eighth note pattern. I'm going to highlight all my hi-hats, bring those up in terms of their velocities, and then I'm going to do something else, which, because I'm going to be doing some duplicating, I'm going to select the first one, the third, every other, and I'm going to bring those velocities up a little bit higher to accent them a little bit. OK. Okay, and this is where I want you to make your own beat, because I already am kind of questioning stuff. So, but you can follow this, you can follow it and then change it. That's fine. I'm going to take this measure that I just made and duplicate it. I'm going to go back into it and I'm going to change that one slightly. Don't want it to be the same, but I'm definitely going to put that in there. Yeah, I'll leave it like that. Okay. All right, I'm going to duplicate this for now. I am going to come back to this section and put in some cymbals, like psh, psh, psh. We want to kind of accent that as well. But for now, you know, as long as it's on beat, it's going to be fine. You really know how to make me cry when you give me those ocean eyes. I'm scared. Oh, keeps going, huh? Falling into your ocean eyes, those ocean eyes. All right, I won't even get into that right now. Okay, so we just kind of established our little bit more energetic drum beat. Let's create, let's change our keys. Okay, so this was what I was mentioning kind of last minute. I don't love that sound. I like it. And I actually want it to be part of my overall sound. But what I'm going to do, and you can do it too if you'd like, is this is called a part. And there can be up to four parts in a patch on expand. So I'm going to click in this green zone, actually this arrow. I'm going to go into soft pads. And I'm going to choose a basic sine pad plus. And that is now added to the piano sound. I can turn off the piano sound and have all the pad, but I don't want that. And I can balance their volumes using these horizontal faders. I'm going to turn off the pad for a moment. And then I actually going to go a little bit further, and you should probably be on easy here. I want you to click on, or I'm going to click on A. You can if you want. And this knob should be here. And I'm going to soften it. So the brightness of that piano goes away a bit. Attack is essentially how hard the sound is. It's actually how fast it gets to volume, but it comes off sounding hard. Then add the pad in, and I have more atmosphere immediately. That's really long though, isn't it? Let's look at 2B. It's the hall. Sure what that is. Easy decay, maybe? Not so much. All right, I like it, it's just a little long. Let's add bass. So I'm gonna highlight my drum track so that the next track that I make will come in between drums and the master fader. Track, new, it should be mono, instrument. Let's name it bass. And the bass doesn't come in until inside those ocean eyes. Your ocean eyes. All right, right at 14. And I'm going to use expand. I have an idea for a patch already. I'm going to go into synth basses, and I'm going to choose the clicky DNB bass. And these are all placeholders. You can change them anytime. And I really do hope in some respects that you do and don't make your sound exactly like mine. I don't even know if mine's going to be that good. All right. But at measure 14, we are going to start drawing. And the bass notes that I want to use, I think I'm going to start on C2. And that's going to be for 3/16th notes into D for 3/16th notes, and then E. And that's going to repeat. So I'm going to just come up here and duplicate that twice. Get back in for measure 17. And it's going to go G, B, C. And this is going to be pretty low. G. Ocean eyes, I'm scared. Let's see how that is. Like it. Let's see what we can duplicate here across all of it. Okay, I'm going to highlight multiple tracks. So starting at measure 14, I'm using my grabber tool, highlighting that. I'm going to hold shift, highlight across all four measures there, then just click down. I'm holding down shift still, and that way I can highlight all three tracks. And I'm going to duplicate that. I'm scared. This last measure, so that is already at 21, repeats. Okay, so there's a couple things that I'd like to point out here. I like the direction it's going. So far, so good. We're not even at 15 minutes yet. But these shadows, and I don't know if you're going to have them, but I want to bring their attention to you or your attention to them. They usually indicate that there's some kind of overlap happening. For example, the drums, why aren't they starting right there? And as much as I'll say, I don't want it to necessarily be perfectly on the grid. When I'm using the grid, I do want it to be. And it kind of bugs me when it's not. So sometimes I can go and just kind of move stuff. Now it's on. This one, why? Like, it doesn't need to be shadowed like that. And I don't like when it shadows. I really don't. I mean, it's a little OCD of me, but it is what it is because I don't like it. That's on beat, though, so... The other one that was kind of weird looking here. And then the one that really was concerning is there. That one kind of inserted a bit of odd silence. So I don't want that. So I'm going to just... Yeah. It's got a weird bug about that. But anyways... So this is the duplicate. So if we work in fours again, Control C or Command C, drop my, no, not that, please. Drop my cursor at measure 17. And copy that. Interesting, that's not playing. I can explain that. That's actually, I can't. They're overlapping. Somehow they are overlapping. Yeah, there that is. But I'm actually going to get rid of this anyways. I kind of like. I've been walking through. Do I want to get rid of that? I've been walking through. No, I'm going to leave that. I'm going to duplicate the drum and not have anything come in. Using the two measure loop that I basically made. Remember, this is the repeat, so from 20 to 21 would work, or I suppose from 18 to 19. I've been walking through a world gone blind. Nah, I'm gonna change that, but let's listen to the original. That is walking through a world gone blind. Can't stop thinking of your diamond. Okay, I still like this, but I will go back to without the hi-hats. So I'll bring the energy back down. So I'm using 12 and 13 copy. Paste that. And remember, you have to be in grid mode for this, or you're dropping stuff in bad spots. World gone blind. Can't stop thinking of your toll. By the way, our tempo's pretty good right now. Alright, we'll spend some time looking for those other weird sounds. Thinking of your diamond. Get our bass over there. So using from 18 through 21, but I'm not going to have it here. So I will copy that just so everything's on, but I'm going to cut out 23. I've been walking through the world. Okay, let's leave it. What am I listening to? Oh yeah. Listen to the good stuff, of course. So they have it in there. It sounds good. I've been walking through a world gone blind. Can't stop thinking of your diamond mind. Careful creature made friends with time. This duplicate, last one duplicate. Oh, no, undo. Last one copy. Yeah, last one duplicate. drums. What to do with the drums.
Oh, creature.
That'll be copy, paste here. Copy, paste, paste. Copy, oops, paste. And then duplicate.
You're lonely with a diamond mind and those ocean.
And we're about halfway through, and there's going to be a lot more duplicating, a lot more layering. I'm going to save it here, or I'll just let me get out of here.